Hey everyone, it's Tony for eModels.co.uk. I don't think I did that in the last episode. Sorry about that. Anywho, welcome to part 10 of the Yamaha YZR M1'09 build in 1/12 scale. I've cut it up. It's not easy to say that one. Anywho, in this episode, I'll not keep you too long, we shall be building the front end of the Yamaha. It's absolutely gorgeous. I mean, look at that brake caliper. Look at it. Focus! Focus! Look at that brake caliper. So, you go that way, I think. Yeah, that way. Go watch, and I'll see you in a minute. So, just off camera, I've painted the splash guard holdy bracket thing. I know. I'm useless with the anatomy of a bike. What I need to do now is fill in that great big huge nut. If we look at the photo, again I'll do a scan of this so we can pick up the detail properly. We've got the axle itself, the big nut for that is painted black in the photo. So I'm going to pick that out with rubber black rather than true black, just to give it something a little bit different, again just to distract your eye away from big lumps of black all the time. What we need to do is take care of the red lettering inside that brake caliper. I've got a cracking technique for that in a minute. But also, if we have a look at the brake disc itself, you can see there's two shades of metal. So you've got like the metallic grey that we used earlier on the disc itself as a base colour. But if I look, there's a slightly lighter shade of metal in there. So I'm going to do that in flat aluminium just to see what it's like. I've got a great technique for that too. So if we have a look at that now, just take the tape off and walk it inside. Hopefully you can pick out, there's two lines. So you've got the disc itself and then you've got a tiny little line there. Just above my fingernail. Now I could spend about 4 hours with masking fluid and masking tape and things like that, getting all that sorted out. Or I could just do that and sellotape it to the back of one of these stencils. As you can see there, we've got the line picked out nicely. You know, it's not exact, but it's not a problem. So we can take care of that with a wash. Not a problem at all. So, I'm just going to get some scrap. You'll do. Just protect the table a little bit. And get some paint ready. Oh, my white balance doesn't like that. Kink out my air hose. Right then, so in the cup we've got flat aluminium straight from the jar, no mix, no thinning down or anything like that, so it's straight. I'll try and get you close enough so that I can see this and show you at the same time. So we're just going to very gently test the floor again, make sure we're working. Just a very gentle nip. Oh, that's one side. Let's give that a few seconds to air dry. Pop that off. Slightly off, but I'm not too bothered about that. Like I say, we can take care of that with a wash in a moment. That saves about 4 hours work. Lovely. Oh, my tripod's not cooperating. Stay right then. Let's grab this nut. Nice to spray paint my finger again a minute ago. It's great. I'm working on another build at the same time as I'm doing this. So those things are drying. I can kill two birds with one stone. So just going to very carefully pick all these out. On the nut. You can see I'm brushing my fingers against each other so that we're not shaking about all over the place. Quiet again, I'm concentrating. There we go. Another good one. Lovely. Okay. And if we have a look underneath, there's like a split pin effect again. Just there at the bottom. We can grab that with a wash. We'll drop some washing, like we did with the engine. But like I said, I was jumping ahead of myself a little bit. So I'll explain that properly in a moment. So it's gonna leave all that to sort itself out now. Let that paint dry for a while, and then we'll gloss varnish. Do a pin wash again, and yeah, we'll do it. I'm going to use MIG 502 Starship Filth, as you can see there. Again, this one's like rocking horse poo, but black will do. This is just a really dirty grey. I'm just going to throw a blob in, mix it all around. More thinner there than paint, as we can see. So just gonna mess about with the consistency. Just put another drop in. Give it a good mixing. It's a little bit too thin. So throw some more in. Don't forget, for this bit, use a grotto brush. As you can see, the bristles on this one aren't exactly in fantastic shape. There's my pin wash brush there, so my pin wash brush. It's a bit better. So let's see how that goes. And then, with the pin wash brush that we used in the engine section. Oh, focus. There we go. Nice thin one. And we're going to... which one should we work on? It's going to show up best, that one. Put that a little bit. There we go. Hopefully you'll see this zipping around everywhere that we delve into, especially in there. So we're just adding a shadow now where there isn't any. Now with a cotton bud, just wipe away the excess, and that's why we use a gloss varnish too, to enable us to do that. If we use a mat, the paint would just sit. The wash even would just sit where we put it. It doesn't move around as easily. So we're just going to go in all the crooks and nannies. Like we do with the engine, wipe away the excess while it's still wet. And the gloss as well helps with the capillary action, just to zip everything away. There's some details there as well. Just liven that up a little bit. And bring in a brake caliper. So we're just going to go around all the nuts and bolts and things like that. All the panel lines are shining horribly. So hopefully you can make that out. Camera's struggling like mad to focus on that. Sorry about that. Hopefully now you can see that nice little that line right down the centre of the caliper, which probably shouldn't be there, but I can't quite tell. My engineering expertise doesn't go that far. Ooh, that was a good one. Just in this section here, and hopefully I'm struggling with my balance on this one today. Yeah, I think it's time for a new camera. Just pick out just that top section there, where the shadow is. It's lovely. So I'm going to carry on doing that. So, like I say, the camera's fighting like mad for focus. I'm just basically going to zip around and do everything that we've just worked on. Hopefully I can catch this one before it gives up the ghost completely. Access. There we go. So again, we're just tricking the eye into thinking there's a depth there when there isn't any. Like so. Lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. And while we've got it out as well, we're just going to have a quick check around the engine. Just make sure we haven't missed anything. Like there. Just picking up details on that pipe, and then the turbo thing that I don't think is a turbo. Just to pick that shadow out there. So it's just run around now, just catch everything that you think you've missed. There as well. Look at these little cogs as well. It's not cog at all, is it? And that's a bit of gear and swing arm bolt thing. Ugh. That there. We should have the back wheel section. quick look around that as well. Just gonna add some more to that rear cog. Just define that a little bit more. That's not too bad. There we go, we need to do our suspension as well. There we go. Hopefully you caught that one. That was a good one. As was that one. Didn't catch it on this side. Right, stay in focus. Ooh, there. That'll be a good one. Focus. Like that. That's a good one. I like that. There we go. That was a good one. There we go. Perfect. So, if nothing else, that last one then summed up everything we're trying to do. Like that. Ooh, there's another good one. Just run around and catch all these. Go on, focus. So it's just a bit more depth to the rivet, not rivets, the vents. Lovely. So this is where my camera really does let me down now. Oh, just get a background. Because it switches itself off, saying it's got a full battery when it hasn't, and then all of a sudden there's a little message pops up right there in that bottom corner. Charge the battery. So I really do need a better camera now, so I can do all this ridiculously tiny close-up work. So in there, if we can focus, we've got a Brembo, I think it is. Brembo, something like that. Signed. They actually give you a decal for that, but as you can see, it's recessed. You should be able to pick out a shadow there, hopefully. So what we're going to do is, rather than use a decal for that, because you won't be able to get the decal to conform to that little gap, I'm going to use some oil paint. Again, MIG 502 Abteilung. And this is brick red from the Urban Weathering set, I think it was. Again, available from eModels. I'm telling you, if they haven't got it, you don't need it. So, the same brush that we used earlier, the tiny little detail brush. Focus. The tiny detail brush we used for the pin wash. I'm just going to, from the cap, because we literally don't need a great deal of this. So just from the cap. Completely neat. Just going to dollop this in. So I'm not going to be careful or anything like that. As you can see, I'm just whacking it in. And hopefully, if I've got this right. Cottonwood, come here. If I've got this right, that should just wipe off now. Leaving behind Brembo. Go on, focus. There we go. I like that a lot. So we pop that off to one side, do the other one as well. He says, come here. So my building schedule and my working life at the moment means that I've now got quite a few long shifts in a row coming up, so I can actually afford to leave this for a couple of days to dry off. Not a problem. There we go. You can actually use a glove. It's actually better than this. I just smeared it everywhere. And there we go. Don't mind that in the background. There we go. So we'll leave that to dry for a couple of days. And then we can seal that in again with a gloss varnish. Magic. And what we need to do now as well is right at the end of, just here. Get a pointy stick. Ted, I need your pointy stick, love. There we go. Right, stay focus. This tiny little section here where the hole's attached to needs to go into where the hole's attached. Needs to be metallic blue, I think it was. Just going off the photos. So I'm going to touch them in as well while we're here. That part right there. So we'll do the same on the other caliper. Quite a few gurgles going on in my belly today. Don't like that. More were there. So let's stand off the rear section, because I've got to paint that part metallic blue too, where the brake holes are touches. Got a bit silly like that. Yep. I don't think it calls for that in the instructions, but might as well. It just breaks up. That's a little bit more colour. There we go. Lovely. So I'll draw that back on. Put that back onto the stand. Why are you still filming this part? You don't need to film this part. You utter hinge. Let's build the front end. I'm getting all excited again now. I'm getting all giddy. I always do when I start building things again. Nope, put it that way around. Yeah, it's a good start, isn't it? So I'm going to need a little bit of persuasion. Just to go in. There's a little bit too much paint building up around this piece here. Focus. The stubble actually goes into the headstock itself, so I'm just going to scrape that back a little bit. Nothing serious, it's just expose the plastic a little bit just to help it go in. Rolling all over the bloody place as well. Lovely! There we go, that's better. So, get the long screw. Where's that thing here? So that's the, let me see, the 16mm long screw. So it's going to get, ooh. It's a bit too tight. Gotta say, get that a little bit tight. You can see there the squeak. There's a bit too much paint on the peg itself. So we'll take care of that as well. Let's do it properly. Let's take that screw back out. There we go. Push that back out. Gently does it. Oh, you can see how tight that is. Block! Probably see there on the underside where we're actually starting to wear through paint. Oh, that piece. So I'm just going to run around with the knife as well, just on the inside. Yeah, nothing too serious, just to, oh my word, that's a big chunk of paint. Just free things up a little bit. Get that way around. There we go, that's better. That is better, so just be aware of that. And we need the flat edge to the front. It's like an arrowhead shape. So flat edge to the front. Draw that screw back in again. Lock that out. So we need that screw tight enough that it's caught the bottom piece, but loose enough that you can still turn the handle bars. I nearly sneezed then. Right, so let's start, pull that to one side and then rebuild these front ends. Right, off camera, again, I've taken care of a decal. Get away from the logo. Come on, focus. It's right there in front of us. Come on, focus. Focus. So I've taken care of the decal, which my camera is struggling like mad to pick up. But you can see the shine there. That's another coat of gloss varnish over the top just to take care of it. helps seal that decal in as well. That colour is absolutely gorgeous, it really is. I'm happy with that colour. And then we need the brass part as well. So the little brass tubing. And then the decal obviously goes to the outside. That's the part that we see. And then very carefully remove the masking tape. Nicely, nicely. Revealing the working parts. That's a bit awkward. Second I take it away, it pops in. Just to make me look silly. So that's that one. Same again. Take the masking tape off to expose the other side. Just let the brass ring over first. And then the suspension arm. Like so. So that's that ready. And then we get the wheel, making sure we're facing the right way. So it's the blades going forward, like so. So this is left-hand side of the bike, facing forward. And we're going to... I'm going to see if I can get away without painting... gluing these together. So I'm lining the tabs up. There's a little pin with a tab at the back. So that's that one. And again, there's a little locating stub on there. The back edge. I don't remember this being this fiddly whilst I was building it the first time around. But then again, I've had cheesecake since. I have had a lot of cheesecake since. I'll do the same on the other side. Just line the tubs up. Where have you gone? Line the top up. Line the top up. Drop the hub in. Put this on. Put this on. It's looking like I will have to glue this disc onto the hub. It's getting a bit fiddly now. I was hoping I could get away with that. So I could display them separately if I needed to. No, it's looking like I'm going to have to glue that. That's a shame. Right, make sure the vent goes forward. Oops, where did it come from? That's A. Right. So, let's put the wheel down. So we push that one into the hole at the top, and there's a little pin that lines up with the hole just here somewhere. I promise you, there you go. Just line that up. Same this side. Like so. How many of you are screaming at your TV right now? Just glue it! Okay. Just glue it! There we go, right. My Hoosie Blonde screw. I think that's the 20mm screw. Just gonna nip that in. Just glue it. Right, fine, I'll glue it. I've been beaten by bits of plastic, I'll admit it. Drop them, take that out of your mouth. Speak properly. Just drop some glue over the top there. It's those two stubby things. Oh, hello, you're stuck. Oh, you are stuck. I know, I should have glued them all along, I know. But it worked in the pre-build, before I started whacking on all the paint, it worked. It was fine. Right, I'm just going to pause there, let that sort itself out for a few minutes, and I'll go get my cold coffee. Okay, right. We'll try again. Yeah, I know, I should have done it all along. Euro brake disc. You in there. And for the most part, it holds it all together when you drop those two hubs in. Right. Throw the screw in. Make sure it catches on the opposite side, like so. Screw it in. Well, make sure it's still freewheeling. It's a shame you can't freewheel the back wheel because of the way they've designed the hub. Well, never mind. Right. Before we get too carried away, I'm going to drop that hose back in as well. Right. Now for the fun part. The tiniest logo in the world. I love that. I do love that. It's ridiculously tiny. So we're gonna have to glue that as well. Oh, that is a shame. I was hoping we could get away with a push fit there too. So I'm actually going to drop the wheel back out, just so I don't glue the wheel together. Just make sure that it's quite square on. I'll do the same on the opposite side. Where have you gone? There you are. I do love that. That tiny little logo. I can't believe they gave you a decal for that and they've got recess. All you need to do is just drop some oil paint in. So I'm just going to rotate that way. My mum's watching Facebook videos again. I just caught a glimpse, no, just caught some audio from downstairs. It sounded quite rude too. She gets these links off one of her friends. And you think it's gonna be a sweet and innocent video and it's actually naughty noises. And she sits there then going, oh shh shh shh. It's funny. She won't learn. It's always the same friend. It's always the same kind of videos. So, Mum, you won't learn, will you? I thought she was going to be nice to me this time, but no. It's Sandra, she won't be nice. I don't know. Right. Give that another 5 minutes or so. And I still haven't drank my cold coffee. What? Cold coffee? Right there. Right there. Right next to me. Right next to a precarious edge. I'm surprised I've not knocked that over yet. So I'll not tempt fate any further. I'll drink that now. Right, where were we? That'll do, I think. Right, where were we? Okay, so that's had a few minutes to sort itself out and dry off and things like that. So making sure that the vents go in the right way around again. The vents being these spokes. Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing. Stop giggling, I know what I'm doing. Do we? Alright, so lining the brake discs up inside the calipers, he says, and then run the screw through. So I've got the discs inside the calipers now. We've got a bike. Kind of, have we? There we go. Get the screw through all the way through to the other side. And suspension arms, there we go. Oh, don't drop it like that. Oh my word. So you had to drop something at some point. Do you know, I think I put that wheel on the wrong way around. Have I? No. No, it was, no, no, ignore me. Oh, right. So, just going to take one of these clamp pieces here, which will go just in here like this. What so? So it's a shame that we're going to have to glue that in and damage that, that lovely paint job. Ooh, no. No, 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 no. I can use the gooey stuff. Alright, get a glove on. So don't go dotting any fingerprints in. This gooey stuff's more like a super glue gel. Even though it is actually a polystyrene glue. Yeah, a tiny bit on the pin. Just get it in there. There we go. That was a better one. Lovely. What else is there? There we go. Nice piece. Now, off camera, so we can't all do this now. So that's a really, really delicate part. We've got this this steering brace. So the tape was to give me something to grab hold of whilst I was painting. Hopefully you can see this on camera. Come here. Come here. The rest of it we've painted with X11 chrome at this end, and the main part of the bar in gold, which was X12. And the whole point of this thing is, let's grab over that, and then push that through there like so. So the middle part that we've not painted doesn't really matter because it's hidden inside, and then there's like a steering lock then. So this is a limiter, I think, on the racing bike to stop you steering right away around, and then, you know, at high speeds, obviously that will be quite nastily dangerous. So I just need the screws now, if I can find the screw bag. Make your own jokes. Oh! And we need, where'd you go? The 4mm black screws. Which will be these fellas here. So that's one, let's do the next server. Again, just wetting the end of my finger, which should hopefully hold that in place, and then whack this over the top. Screw through very, very carefully. Just don't forget we just glued this. Ideally, you can obviously leave this glued to set. Going to screw that home. It does tell you in the instructions to screw this in before you glue that part to the suspension arm, and I can see why now, because your levers get in the way. The instructions do things in a particular order for a reason most of the time. Don't ignore them like I do. Okay, so that's in there. And we need to screw the arm to chassis. To chassis. See, I'm going on northern on you now. Still, could be worse. I could be using the BBC received pronunciation accent. Good evening, here it is, the news. Oh, I cannot nonsense. No. Let's go northern. Who? Winter is coming. No, stop it. That's another show. Stop it. Yeah. This settles it. I'm definitely getting some proper screwdrivers. A limiter, lovely. Oh, I'm doing it again, lovely. Right, so we'll bob that off to one side. Pull that off to one side, and then we've got some more lengths of cabling to cut. I'm going to leave that until the last, because two of those cables. Three cables attached to the handlebar grips themselves. Don't know what that is. So we'll leave the rest of that cabling to the last. But what I have done, I saw it a second ago, where have you gone? There you are. There's a connector piece for all the cabling that in between takes. Painted black with metallic blue bolt heads, like you're supposed to. And then give it a couple of coats of gloss varnish. So that'll be ready when we come back for all the hosings and stuff like that. So we'll have a look now at the exhaust. I know. I'll try that again. The ending is almost in sight. Very, very almost in sight. So I'll give you a quick glimpse into what we can expect for part 11 of the Yamaha build. Where's the radiator gone? There's the radiator. So, in the next show, we shall be dealing with the exhaust and the radiator. And getting all those sorted out. Get a shine on that. That's lovely. And I'll be going through how I did all the exhaust staining. And things like that. So, join me then. In the meantime, bob along. See my mates at eModels.co.uk. Tell them I sent you. And they'll ask for a ransom. They've got Cuddles, my monkey. They've got Cuddles. No, they haven't. If you haven't got it, you don't need it. Bob along, tell them I sent you. Buy one of these bikes. You need one of these bikes. Trust me, you need it. Get the other half to buy you one for Christmas. You'll be forever grateful. I'll tell you, you will be. If not, treat yourself for Christmas. They don't have to know. I won't tell. See you in episode 11. Cheerio!